Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And in this video I will take you through how to configure network resource availability of network resource and contents. So basically it is all about how to configure Windows Server backup and restore. Okay, and guys, this is my 34th video in this series, which is Windows Server 2019 training. In this video we'll see couple of steps, like what and all we can do, how to install and configure backup feature, create, share, restore from that backup, and enable shadow copy. And before that, you should understand couple of basic theoretical part about it. So you know, Windows Server backup is Windows Server 2008 feature, basically 8 and now 12 16 19, whichever is available operating system. And it provides, you know, couple of services like basic backup and recovery solution for server on which we have configured this or we have installed this. Okay, and it has replaced, if we talk about Windows Server 2008, so it has replaced couple of backup features from earlier operating system. And objective of this video is to make a Windows Server backup and restore and configure shadow copy. So guys, before going that, I would like to tell you about couple of features, what are the features and improvement in this latest version of Windows Server. So first of all, if you see faster faster backup technology, so you can have two options, like this shadow copy service, so which allows you to take backup or recover of your recovery of your operating system files, folders and volumes. Simplified restoration, you can, you know, you can select what you want to restore, that is specific file, folder or content. And recovery is also possible here. Backup works with new Windows recovery tool to make it is easier what you want to recover. And ability to recover applications like backup uses VSS functionality that is built into application like SQL or SharePoint service to protect application data. You can schedule using scheduling option. Okay, and even you can create multiple disks to save your backup, and you can use those at the time of disaster protection for disaster protection. And you can remotely manage it through MMC and automatic disk usage management, like you should not you do not need to worry about disk usage. Okay, so it will manage automatically. You can enable compression and all. So these are the basic feature, or you can say improvement on this Windows Server backup feature. Now you should understand one more thing, what is like who can take backup. So backup operator and administrator group member have access to the backup tool, and you can delete these rights to other group or individual. Now you should understand what is system state data. So system state data is like, you know, if you are taking backup, system state backup, then it will contain couple of things, like, you know, boot MGR files, boot configuration data, which is known as BCD, and boot volume, like where operating system is installed and registry, system volume, sysvol tree, and directory database, which is Active Directory database, ntds.dit, and Active Directory database log file. So this is very important, you should know. And in the interview also they will ask what is system state data backup basically. So it will contain this much information. And what you should understand now, what is shadow copy. So guys, shadow copy is also a tool or service of Windows Server backup to recover your files. It uses previous version concept basically. So previous version feature in Windows Server 2008 or now in 12 16 and 19 enables your users to access previous version of file. If accidentally you deleted, you can recover. If you accidentally overwrited something on that, you can recover your previous version of file, and you can compare. So we will understand how to enable it in this video. And these are the steps we are going to follow in this video, like create, share, manually backup, restore, configure shadow file, enable shadow, change file location and all. And guys, scenario, you are an administrator or you are working as Windows infrastructure service technology specialist, and they have given you work like you need to configure disaster recovery, restore and availability for all critical services. This is what they have given and you have to deploy. And here I'm using two virtual machines. One is my Active Directory and one is my another secondary server. And guys, at the end, if you feel this video is informative, don't forget to like this video, share this video, like this video and comment. And don't forget to hit this bell button on your YouTube channel. So guys, here I here I have two virtual machine. One is my Active Directory and one is secondary server. And if you want to see, let me go to my server manager here. Okay, on both the server. So I will use my Active Directory as a backup server, and this will be my another server. So here I think server manager is open. So as you can see here, this is my local server. This is a member of my domain. My domain is india.com. Win SVR one is a system name. Okay, and apart from this, couple of roles and features I have installed, but we'll use this as a secondary server. Now this is my Active Directory. As you can see here, I have installed Active Directory, certificate service, domain service, DNS, and couple of more. And if you go to local server, you can find it like it is Vinady's name, and it is a domain which is india.com. Okay, india.com. And now here, first of all, you have to install this feature. Just go to role and feature and click next. And here if you go down, you will find Windows Server Backup, and just click next. Okay, and if restart is required, it will restart. You click install. Now at the same time, you need to create one share folder on your secondary server, that is remote. So I am going to my C drive. I have only C drive here. I don't have much drive, more drives. Okay, so I am going to C drive. Either I can create by right clicking here, or I can go to this wizard only. And if I go to files and storage services, here I can go to shares. And as of now, I have created one share VPN, and I don't require. So I can create one more here. From here, just give to go to task and give quick. I'm going with this, and just you can see where you want to keep it. I want to create in C drive, and I'm giving name net backup 2019. Okay, I'm giving this, and this is my path, remote path. So let me just give next here, and I'm going with this allow caching of share. And now you can, if you want, you can customize the permission, but here I think this built-in administrator is having complete full access. And if you want, you can go to property, and even you can add a couple of users if you want. So here I'm not adding anything. If required, I can add later on. Okay, so even you can change if you want to change who will be owner, like that. So I'm not doing this. Let me just try one authenticated user I want. So here authenticated, I'm just selecting this one also. Okay, and okay. And here authenticated users we got. So it became owner now. Okay, so what I'm going to do, replicate owner, this also, and this also I'm doing, and just apply. Yes, and we'll see if any error comes later on, we can change. So here now just give next and create it. So it will create one folder, and let me go to that folder here, C drive. And as you can see, if you refresh it, you will get that share. And as of now, we don't have anything on this folder, only empty folder. Now I will use this Active Directory what we have installed here, that feature, to do one manual backup. Okay, so you need to go to this feature, and here guys, let me show you. So I have done, you know, manually I have created one share. We have done two steps. Now I'm manually backing up one file and keeping it network location. Okay, network location means secondary server. So this is it will give you some my old configuration information. Okay, so here click on local backup, and you can create one backup from this side. Here you will get options. Okay, it is loading information. So these are my old, and I think today only I had created, and it was successful. So I don't require this one. I want to create one backup once option from here. Okay, and I'm going with different option. Click here next, and it is asking now select backup configuration. So full server you would require 21.21 GB data. So I want to go with this custom, and here I will select what I want to backup. Even you can go to this advanced setting, and here you can select what you want. Like you want to exclude something, then you will have to add, or if you want this VSS full backup. So I will use VSS full backup because this says choose this option if you are not using, if you are not using any other product to backup, or if you are using any other product for backup or any application, then you should this copy. So I'm selecting this first one and just add item what you want to backup. I want to backup, you know, I have some this folder, okay, testing folder, and just give next here. And it is asking where you want to keep this. Select destination. Either you can use local drive or you can use share folder. So I'm using share folder, and my share folder is what it is, like, you know, win hyphen svr1, and we had given this path, sorry, this is s, and I hope you remember this. It is coming automatically, net backup 2019. Okay, and if you go, you can verify this only here from here, net backup 2019. Okay, or even if you can check here, like what it will come, win win hyphen svr1 give slash, and it is coming. That is all we want. Okay, this one. And just give next here, or you can select like you want inherit or you don't want. So I want inherit, just click next and backup. So it will take some time. It will give you the statistics of this backup, how much data it is transferring, how much data is transferred, like that. Okay, and it will be coming here, this folder. As of now, there is nothing in this folder, so that backup is not completed yet. So now it is showing you, like, you know, data transferred 0 KB and total is 100 MB. Now it is telling you how much is configured, so you can it is completed. Now you can monitor from here, and it is telling you status completed. You just close this, and even you can find this information here, backup completed at what time and all. Now if you refresh this, you got one backup image here. Okay, one some data here from our that Active Directory. So we will recover that folder from here. We will not see what and all we have taken backup, but it is coming here only. These are the file what we have selected from this Active Directory. Okay, so now what I want to do, I want to delete that file from here, that folder from my drive. Let me go to E drive. Okay, I came to F, E drive, and this testing I am deleting here. I deleted. Now I don't have that file here, so that file is available on my secondary server. Okay, so I want to recover from here. So how can I recover it? I just need to go to once again tools, and this is called manual. Okay, and now I will have to use recover option. This recover option, go to recover. Now it is asking this server WinAD or backup on another location, what you want here. You have to select, you have to choose. Okay, so here you can another server you should select. Okay, this server backup another server location, you can find it out, getting it started. This is the option, and just click next here. Now what is location type where the backup is stored, it is asking. So it is shared. Once again, you should select share folder and just give once again WinSVR1 and put hyphen, and it is coming. That folder is basically, and it is coming that location. Just click next, and now it is asking, as you can see here, they have a couple of backups. Okay, so it is showing you latest backup, which is 11/8. Okay, and date it also you can change if you have multiple backup, or you can say here oldest available backup 888, newest available backup 11. This is showing you date and timing also. We are going with this latest only, and click next, and it is asking like what you want, what do you want to recover, file and folders or volume or what. So we are just want to recover files and folders, and if you want volume any drive, then you should select this, but I want this, and just click next, and it is asking you select item to recover. what you want to recover. So this is volume. I want to recover this testing folder and click next. And now it is asking create a copy so that you have the both version, or specify recovery option it is asking. Okay, so here you should select default only. Okay, create copy, so it will be available with both version. And here so it is asking where you want to keep another location or same location. So I want to go with the same volume might fail due to unsupported file property. So let me put some other, if it is coming like that. So just I'm going to select this. Okay, I can define where I want to keep it. So I'm just going with this, and as you can see here, it is showing you this much files are going to be recovered, and just click recover it. So as you can see here, it is showing you recovery process, and it is showing application completed, and it is even showing how much data it is containing. And if you go to Active Directory now, your drive and volume, E drive, and here users. Okay, and this is what we had inside that, you can find here. So this is, we got all the information what we had lost or I had deleted, and you are able to see each and everything here. Okay, completely what and all we had. So guys, this is what we can, you know, restore and create. Now I will show you how to enable shadowing, or how to configure shadow copying. Okay, so for that you need to go to, you know, computer management on Active Directory only, because this is our backup server, so we have to use this only. And here go to computer management. So now you have to go to computer management of Active Directory. Okay, for this installation, so just let me expand this here. You know, first of all I will show you a couple of things. So guys, here I have three drive. One is my C drive, operating system drive, and two drive, other drive, data drive, like I can keep data. So one is E drive and one is F drive. So what I'm going to do before telling you what and all I need to configure here, E drive I used for backup, this drive I used, now I have this drive. So I will make this drive as a shadow, and for that what you need to do, I have created one folder here, okay, test, and I gave name shadow test. Okay, and I made one entry 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 0 on this, and now I will share this drive itself, complete drive, it should be shared, and everybody should have complete access permission. So I'm going sharing, and here permission to everyone I'm giving, like, you know, full access. Even you can add if you want authenticated user here, authenticated user. Okay, authenticated, select this and give complete permission. We are done with this. So I have shared this drive, whatever data is shared in this will be available throughout the network. Okay, so we will use basically this folder. Okay, and now you have to go to tools here, and computer management to enable shadowing. Here share folder, you should right click, all task, configure shadow copy option. And as you can see here, as of now F drive it is disabled, and even E drive it is disabled. So I'm using F drive, and I have two options here. One is like setting, I can configure a couple of things, like, you know, location of drive. I can even allow here maximum size and all. I can schedule automatic shadowing at what time it should happen, like that. Schedule task weekly, daily, monthly, once, like that. And timing I can fix here, every how after how many, you know, days or weeks it can happen. And here from here we can even set this scheduling timing and all. Renew you can put like this. Okay, and I'm not doing anything here, I'm going with default only, because we will do in this video manual only. And just click cancel here, and you should enable. Okay, just click enable, and it is enabled. As you can see here, one shadow copy is selected and created here at this time. Now if you click on this, you can revert, you can delete, you can create now. So as of now, I just enabled it. I have not created any shadow copy. So before that, let's go to client computer. This is my client computer, okay, and let me log in this. We will access that file and verify something. So here guys, let me just, you know, close this, and I will open that drive. So that is my F drive here, okay, and that folder F drive I opened, and that folder is shadow, and this shadow test. So as you can see here, I have altered here, I mean some data is coming, and I'm just closing it. And now if I go to this folder, so even I have not made any change here, okay, so I'll leave it this one. And as you can see here, it is having lots of data, okay, so that is not required for me. I'm just going back, okay, and just clicking on this property, and I'm going to previous version. So as you can see here, this shadow is showing me some sort of 30 today's date, and 10 4 it made one shadow copy. And if you go to open this, it is giving you same information, okay. So now what we need to do, even for this, if you go, it will show you same thing, previous version. So it is telling you and all the information, whatever it is available. If you go to property, it will show you one shadow copy. Oh, it is not coming any document. It should be any document. Nothing is there. Backup, if you click on this, let's see. I'm just trying to explore things, okay, but we'll see only that text file, which is important. And now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to alter something on this. I'm just making some changes. I'm giving A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, okay, and I'm just saving this. Control S, I did Control S, and I'm closing this main file, okay. Even I have closed this, and all each and everything on client computer. And now if I go to my Active Directory, you can click this, okay, and open the drive and check this. It is showing, it is not showing me anything. Let me just refresh it. On this, let me see, we have altered. Oh, I think it is not saving. So I'm giving one, again, I'm giving my name. Okay, I gave my name, and I will save it. Just give save and click it. Go to this now, refresh this and open. So it is showing you now, okay. So if you go to this property and version, previous version, so it is having only one shadow copy, okay, which was created at 9:54 today. Now I want to create manual shadow copy. We had enabled that at that time, that got created. Now I will create one manual. So again, I need to go to control manage, computer management, configure shadow copy, and here select this and create now. Okay, so now as you can see here, at 10:08 a.m. it has created one more copy. If you want, you can just click one more, selecting this. So it has created two copy. So now just give OK. And if you wish, you can go to share, and you can refresh this site drive here, okay, like this, and F only, and just now go back to client computer and refresh here also, so that it should have two now. Let's go to shadow copy and right click. It should show two version. So still it is showing one. It takes some time to replicate here, okay, so we'll have to wait for that. So sometimes it takes 5 minutes or 10 minutes or like that. It just depend on the, you know, how much RAM or capacity you have on your system. So that is also a big factor. And that is Win, AD, and then F and shadow folder I'm opening. And I'm just going to this one. And again, property, previous version. It will come, it will take some time. And if you go to this folder, you can see it must have created like multiple versions. As you can see here, it has created, so that will also come, okay. And we'll have to wait for that. property, previous version. Here it will come automatically. You will see couple of files. So I'm just pausing, guys, this video. Once it is done, because it will take some time, I will continue. So if you go to this folder, guys, here, like same folder, if you open it, everything is having multiple, you know, versions. Like this folder is having, I gave couple of create now. Even if you go to this main property, it will show you couple of folders. So even this file will show you, you know, same this shadow here, multiple versions. From there we can restore latest one. If you open this, as of now it is showing you only one. It will show you that secondary, what we have altered. Okay, so if you see this, this is altered one. My name should come here when I open this. So it will take some time. Okay, if I open this, it should show my name also. So we need to wait for that. It will come, surely it will come. It comes because that is the concept of it. So here it should show my name. That will be your shadow copy. Okay, so it will reflect. We need to wait for some time. So I'm again pausing this video.
Or guys, we can verify it from here itself. If you go to this client computer, okay, and just open run, and that shared drive and this folder itself, okay, just go to property and see here couple of versions. So how many times I have done it, like, you know, create shadow copy, it has created. So if you look at this, the earlier which one was earlier which was created is at 10:04 a.m. okay, if you open and that text file, it will open and it is having one entry only. Okay, and now if I go back and if I see which was created and at
Now guys, we can verify from here itself. Okay, not an issue. You can go to you know, property of this itself, that folder, and you can go to previous versions, and you can see the first one which was created at 10:04 a.m. and if you open it, it will open that shadow text also. So it is showing one entry only. Okay, and later on it was second created at 10:08 a.m. if you open this, it will open that shadow file. So it is having two entry. Okay, and similarly I have created multiple, only it is not reflecting on that particular. It will reflect, it will take some time. If you open this again, it is showing you two entry, which is created at 10:19. So what I want, like, you know, by mistake, what I'm trying to say here, let me just close this. By mistake on this data, I altered something. Okay, like again I did something A, B, C, D, and I don't want this data. I mean, I don't want this A, B, C, D to be there on my actual data. What I have clicked here, so just let me click S only. And if you go Active Directory and open this shadow file, it is having three entries. So I want to bring back my this text file to my either this first one or second one. So how can I do it from shadow copy? For that, what we can do, let me run one more shadow copy here. Okay, and same, I'm giving this and create now. And if I go to this folder and just close this last, I'll show you. Okay, and just once again let me open this and go to property of this folder and versions. So as you can see here, it has created one more copy just now, like, you know, 10:22 a.m. and if I open the text file, will have three entry now it is having. So I don't want this much information to be there in the text file. I want that two entry file only, okay, at my Active Directory. So I can open this, and this 10:11 a.m. is having two entry. If you open this and see, it is having two entry. So I can just close this and click this itself and just restore it from here. Okay, just restore it and done. It is telling cannot access the complete because the folder, another program it is telling. Try again. I think it is open here. So let me close. where it is open. One minute, let me see what is this now. Here it seems if you go and property just sharing, I think it is you need to. Yes, okay. I think this could be the reason. Okay, it has been, I think I had shared that one twice. So, okay, so I did and it is successfully restored. Even you can see from here itself, if you want to, you know, revert it back, restore it back, you can right click here. So, it will restore from this itself. Now, if you go to Active Directory and open this shadow folder and here this text file, and you will have only two entry. Okay, you will not have three entries. Similarly, if you want to, you know, just restore it to your first state, you can go to this one and select previous versions and restore this first one only. Okay, this is 10:04 a.m. restore it and restore yes, and it is done. Just click okay, and now go back to once again Active Directory and just refresh it and open it. So now it is having only one entry. So this is how guys we can use shadow copy shadowing. Okay, I hope this video will be informative to understand the concept, and if you have any doubt you can put me on comment about it. And for more videos, don't forget to subscribe my channel, comment on this video, share this video and like this video. And next video I'll be talking about, you know, how to configure load balancer, network load balancer, okay, and how to share load between two servers. So guys, we have completed all the steps one by one successfully. And if you feel this video is informative, as I told you once again, I'm telling you, don't forget to like, share and comment on this video and subscribe the channel. So till then, bye bye, have a nice time.